Most of us, we are looking for answers to our daily challenges and difficulties. And there is a very nice story on a meeting that took place between Rabbi Nachman of Breslov to his student Rabbi Natan of Breslov. And Rabbi Natan had a very hard question that he was going with in his mind for a long, long time. And he asked many righteous people and many rabbis for an answer, and no one was really able to answer him. He had an issue with his thoughts that he couldn't stop from thinking. He was all the time thinking, and even he said that on that thing on himself, that even if his thoughts were positive on words of Torah or prayer or something like that, holy thoughts, still his mind was running like a speeding train all the time, very, very like fast and strong and consistent thoughts without the ability to rest and to stop from thinking. And he felt like he needed to rest a little bit from thinking. And he asked many tzaddikim, righteous people, for an advice for that, and no one was able to answer to him. And Rabbi Nachman of Breslov had the answer when Rabbi Natan came to him and started asking that question. So Rabbi Nachman very fast answered to him, simple, the most simple answer that you can even think of, and told him, on everything that you go through in life, you can talk about it with Hashem. It's like, it's the answer, it's the real answer to your problem. Because everyone lives different lives, and everyone are going through different things, and everyone, they have up and downs, and everyone are facing challenges, and everyone has their memories, and their post-trauma, and their emotional pain, and their sorrow, and their fears, and everyone are struggling with difficulties and with other issues, and everyone have like things that they cannot talk to no one about, and that they are embarrassed of, and that they are scared of. Like everyone are trapped in this world. And when you look for salvation, you look for answers, you look for solutions for your issues, for your problems, for your challenges, it's not easy to find. But when you, it's like breathing. When you find that point of faith inside of your heart that you are able to express, no matter what you go through, all your feelings, all your thoughts, with Hashem, and you speak to the Creator like you speak to your best friend, with honor and with appreciation and with respect, by that you can solve all your issues. And many times I said it, and I'll repeat it again because it's so important to know. Even when you want to talk to Hashem, to the Creator, and you can't find words, and you want to pray, and you find yourself with no words, you can also talk to Hashem about that. You can also talk to the Creator about your prayer. You can also go to Hashem and tell Him, listen, I'm trying so hard to talk to you, and I can't find the words. Look what a beautiful prayer you can say only from prayer on prayer. Please Hashem, let me talk to you. Please let me find the right words to speak to you. Please let me remember all the things I need to pray for. Let me remember all my loved ones, all the people I care about. Please let me pray to you in a way that will be respectful for you, that way will praise you, that I'll praise you, that I'll have the merit to please you and to make you happy, and you'll be proud of me. Let me pray, let me talk, I want to make wonders with my prayers, that my prayers will make wonders for other people in their lives. Please let my prayers rise and answer all my prayers. Accept my prayers. You haven't even asked for one thing except for the power of prayer. You understand? And that is the tool, and that is the weapon that we received from the Creator, that He gave to Abraham, to Isaac, to Jacob, the power of prayer. They were the first masters of prayer. They had the ability to break through the curtains of reality and to understand that life is not really what and how they seem to our eyes. the physical world is only a curtain, is only an illusion, it's only a filter who hides the true light of the Creator from the people who are looking at it. The real truth is behind the scene. All the spiritual attachments and all the faith and all the real purpose of every detail and detail in creation. That is the real truth. And the world is only a world of it's all reflections and filters who are presenting something deeper to you. So for an example, if you want to drink now water, if your body needs water, it's not really the water that you need, it's the spark of life that is hidden and treasured inside the water that your soul desire. The verse is saying, "Lo al alechem levado yichya adam," not on the bread itself, on its own, alone, the man will live. It's not the bread itself. A person can eat and die while eating. A person can drink and die while drinking. It's the soul finds its life from spiritual sparks of life that are treasured inside things. This is why when you smell something, even that you didn't take any food into your body, it gives you a boost of life. It gives you energy. You find yourself happy with that. You find satisfaction from that smell. That smell brings you back to life. It refreshes and revives your soul. It reminds your soul of gentle things. And those are spiritual sparks. This is how a person can find himself learning something. A person can tell me, "I watched your video and it saved my life." How can a video save your life? I'll understand if a truck went and almost ran over you and someone took you out of the highway and you've been saved. Okay, I understand he saved your life. I understand that if you were choking from food that stuck in your throat and someone helped you and he took it out, he helped you to breathe. So great, I understand he saved your life. How can a word save a person's life? Because the word holds inside of it a spiritual spark, and that spark was missing from, it was like a link in the chain that was missing, and everything for you was a mess, it was all over the place, and suddenly a class came, a word came, a smile came, a good word, a positive mindset, a view that you saw, anything that came, even spiritual thing, into your mind, and it linked those two sides of that chain, and boom, suddenly you have a clear understanding. Oh, now I know, now I realize, oh yes, you helped me. And you see that there is so much power installed inside of life, that a book can change a person's life, a video can change a person's life, can uplift, can shift you to a different dimension. Like suddenly, hey, I'm not the same person I was before. Like, do you know, like, remind yourself, I can give examples from my own life, but look at yourself. Look where you were 5, 7, 12, 20 years ago. Like, look where your life were. You were such a different person. You were so in such a lower level than the level that you are today. I mean, spiritually, in the level of your awareness, your awareness to details, your way of observation on things, the way of you perceiving life, accepting life, understanding life, seeing every moment as a meaningful moment, having so much honor and respect for people. Look at yourself. Look how much you earned, how much you achieved by following the truth and connecting yourself to Hashem, to the Creator, and first of all to yourself. I said it about myself. I said it many times, my journey in the beginning of my way of tshuva was not searching for God at all. I couldn't care less about God. Unfortunately, that's the real truth. I didn't thought that Hashem was exist at all. If you would talk to me about Hashem, I would laugh. I wouldn't listen to you. I couldn't care less about religion. I was secular. I lived secular life. I was partying. I was doing everything I wanted to do. As a teenager, as a young guy, I was just doing whatever was fun for me. I didn't care about it, but I felt I didn't care about religion at all, but I felt that something is missing, that something is wrong inside of me. And that thing that was missing, that thing that was wrong inside of me, was the fact that I felt that I am betraying myself, that I'm doing things against my true self, that I am not loyal to my inner feeling. Friends were telling me, hey, let's go hang out. I would say yes, even that I didn't want it. I was wearing clothes that was not comfortable for me. I was just trying to show off with those clothings, and I did it against my conscience, against my happiness, against my feeling of comfort and joy. And it was horrible. People are calling you and they don't want to answer and you don't want to talk, but you play nice and you're lying to yourself. And I felt so horrible with myself. And I decided that I must stop working against myself, stop shooting myself in the leg. And then I start looking for myself. Okay, why are you lying to yourself? Why are you hanging out with that person that you feel that is damaging you? Why are you laughing? Why are you making jokes? Why you can find yourself like mocking other person? Why you're not respectful? Why you... All the lackings that I found in myself, I started investigating. I wanted to find my true self. And then when I found a little bit more about myself and I was able to admit my mistakes and to correct them in some ways and to try to improve and to be more honest, with that journey, with those amazing steps, I followed inner and inner into my true self, into my inner zone. And there I found out with myself, in my inner search and inner deep conversation with myself, that I have a soul. That I'm not only the body, that I'm not only Dror, that guy Dror, okay, the one with the will, the one with the desires, the one with the fears, the one with the trauma, the one with the hopes, the one with the talents, the one with the abilities, the one with the lackings. I'm not only that figure, I'm not only that body, I'm also my feelings, I'm also my emotions, and I'm also something that is way more complex than that, way more divine and highly than just a person. And then I started to try to find, what does it mean? Okay, I have a soul. Okay, what is it? Is it an energy field? Is it an aura? Is it life? Is it mine? Is it under my control? Or it's something that I can attach myself to? And then I started to do more and more to understand what's the purpose of my soul. And I read many books and I saw... And I, the social media was not so strong 20 years ago, so there was no many videos and like you couldn't Google those things like 22 years ago or something like that. But I was searching in many books and new age modern spiritual books of guidings. I learned about Vipassana, and I learned about the soul, and I learned about a guided imagination and meditation and many kinds of things. And I went and did the Tai Chi, and I tried many things because I wanted to find myself. And with time, I realized that there is a supervision on my life. Suddenly I realized the things that I'm thinking of are being pulled into my life. I'm thinking about something and a person is talking to me about that thing. I'm looking for a certain subject, or I hope to, and suddenly I find that book in the bookcase. And then I ask myself, if I am the one who pulls that energy, or that energy just show itself to me. And I kept on investigating, and my inner search was to find myself. I wasn't there to become religious at all. I had one day, I remember that day clearly, that I met a Rebbetzin, a woman in Yerushalayim, in Jerusalem, and she like really talked to me in a very, very strong and powerful way, meaningful way for me in those days. And she told me certain things that clarified to me that I'm about to become religious. She told me certain things about myself, and I knew she was right. I felt that she was right. And when I came back home, I sat on the ground and I started crying. I cried to Hashem. I told him, don't do that to me. I don't want to be religious. I don't want to change so much. I believe that you exist, but I don't want to become religious. I don't want to. I didn't want it. I didn't look for that. It was not my purpose. It was not my goal at all. But then I realized with time that there is a creator, that there is a supervisor, and that you can talk to him. And then I started to do hitbodedut on my own. Before I even started to learn books of Rabbi Nachman of Breslov, I was meditating and I was talking to the light. I was talking to Hashem, to the creator. And that light shined to me and pulled me inner and inner and inner and helped me and built me and stabilized me and opened my eyes and healed my spirit in so many ways and helped me to overcome so many fears and anxieties and problems of low self-esteem that I was suffering from. And then I realized that Hashem gave us all this, also the Torah. And I started to be observant, and I started to put tefillin, and I started to wear a kippah, and I started to put tzitzit, and I felt an inner connection to that. But everything came with this honest approach of looking for the truth. I was not, all right, I'm going to convert, I'm going to do tshuva, I'm going to become religious. It was not about religion at all. It was about an inner search of finding the real truth. And for that, you have the power of prayer. The power of prayer is the most powerful tool that we got from the Creator. Abraham, the verse is saying on him that every morning he would go out to the field, to a place that was set for him, out in the nature, and he was talking to the Creator like he talked to the best friend. He was talking the truth. He was begging to the Father in heaven, to the Creator of the world, to the one who creates reality, to reveal his loving kindness on all his creations. And he was talking and talking and talking. And this is by his great action, the sages established for us the morning prayer. And Isaac, Yitzchak, his son, his child, went and did the same in the mornings and in the noontime. And he established for us Tfilat Mincha, the noon prayer, the noontime prayer, the afternoon prayer. And Jacob, he went in the same way and he was also praying at nights. And he established for us the evening prayer, the night prayer, the Ma'ariv. And we're going and praying three times a day because that is the connection. But those written prayers are only to refresh our memory, to remember that we can talk. But the real talk, the real conversation is your individual prayer. That you will open your mouth and talk your heart to the Creator. That you will ask and beg and open your heart and share your thoughts and ask for Hashem for guidings and ask for salvation and ask for all your needs, for all the things that your heart desire. With no end, and never to stop from asking. Never, ever, ever, ever stop from asking. Never, ever. Never, ever to stop from asking and begging and hoping and asking for clarifications. And the ways to do it, hitbodedut, there are so many ways to talk to Hashem. There are so many things that you can talk to. You have a child that needs your help, you can talk about it. Please Hashem, the Creator, Father in Heaven, please help me, Lord, God, my Father. No matter how you feel comfortable calling Him. As long as you're not calling Him in names of people, as long as you don't pray to people, you don't pray like, Moses, help me. You don't say, Moses, help me. You don't say, if you're Muslim, you don't say, Muhammad, help me. If you're Christian, you don't say, Jesus, help me. You don't pray to Jesus. You don't pray to Muhammad. You don't pray to Moses. You pray to Hashem. You pray to the Creator. There is God. God created human beings and all of us were here to succeed and to rise and to understand what the Creator wants from us. You don't pray to people. You never pray to people. You never pray to people. You never pray to people. Even if you go to a person and you tell him, hey, please, can you help me? It's an aspect of prayer. You don't pray to people. You don't give power to people. You don't go to that person and tell him, no, please, can you help me? You don't hang your hopes on him. You don't put your hopes on him. Oh, please, help me. Can you please help me? Can you please provide? Can you please support me? No! You don't put your trust on human beings. You don't put your trust. It doesn't mean that you cannot have trust in your best friend. It doesn't mean that you cannot count on your soulmate. It doesn't mean that you need to doubt your connections with people. No, God forbid. But you must remember and realize that everyone, all creations, we are receiving our energy and our life from the one that is above, from the unity that bonds everything to be one. So you need to pray to that oneness, to that Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Listen, Israel. Our God, our Lord, is one. And He has all the powers. That's the verse. That's the meaning of the verse. Just one God inside of every particle of creation, in and out. The world is full with His honor. And He's the only one to answer all your prayers and all your requests and all the things your heart desire. And that all your prayers will be answered and that all your dreams will come true. But you need to express it. My child, he needs help. Please, Father in heaven, help him. Assist him for him to be focused, for him to be positive, for him to go on straight path, on a great way. My wife, she needs things. Please, Hashem, help her to find the things she needs, that she will not feel miserable, that she will never feel lonely. Please let me know how to help her, how to stand by her side. My parents are old. Please, Hashem, heal them. Please, Hashem, protect them. Let them get older with honor and with respect and give them the strength and power to hold on and to be happy in their aging process and that their children, us, that we will be able to support them and stand by their side. No matter what you want to pray for, please Hashem, change the weather, please Hashem, bring down the rain, please Hashem, wash the world from the filth, please Hashem, bring peace between all different communities in the world. Please Hashem, remove radical, violent people from between us, that there will be no arguments and no wars. Please Hashem, cancel all kinds of racism, that there will be no hatred, no lies. Please Hashem, fix the world. Please Hashem, correct the world. Please Hashem, heal the world. Please Hashem, provide what we need. Please Hashem. And also on the smallest details, please Hashem, I don't find clothes. Please Hashem, I need to find another shirt. I don't know where to buy those tights. I don't know where to find those shoes. Hashem, I saw those shoes. Please bring me those shoes. I need to find those shoes. No matter what you need, a man or a woman, a child or an elder person, a Jewish or an Israeli or a non-Jew, or like, it doesn't matter. You need a house. You need a house. You need a roof. You need a roof. You need the plumbing, the sewer system to work properly. You need to please Hashem. Please Hashem. Please Hashem, help us. Please Hashem, forgive us. Please Hashem, support us. Please Hashem, build us. Please Hashem, stabilize us. Please Hashem, provide. Hashem. And how to do it? Slowly, calmly, and happily. Hatzlacha rabba, be well. Hatzlacha rabba means great luck. Shum davar lo yatzor oti.